Good morning, students. I am Rashmi Yandemis, your science teacher. Students, I hope you understand very well the first part of our lesson, that is the natural resources, air, water and land. In first lecture, we discussed about the air, the content of air, how air is important for plant, for animals, and how air pollution is occur, effect of that air pollution, which gases include into the air, all these things we discussed. I hope you understand it very well. I hope you completed your homework. Now, today, second natural resource, that is the water. You know that water is a very essential content. Why? We heard about that. Water is life. We have to use water very carefully. Here, one activity is there. You can write this activity in your notebook. In one day, purpose for which water is used, okay, and amount of water in liters. For example, for bath purpose, how much amount of water we use for brushing teeth, that approximately that amount you have to write down in liter. And if you calculate the total amount, then you can relate that how much water we use in one day for complete these basic things. There is an impossible for us to spend even a single day without water. We need to drink 3 to 4 liters of water every day so that all our bodily functions run smoothly. Approximately how much amount? In adults, approximately 3 to 4 liters of water is consumed. And this water is essential inside our body because water is an essential nutrient. It regulates, it controls, it works the different functions which occur inside our body. Other living things also require water, although the amount of water they need may vary according to the size of their body. Vary, that is nothing but the different. In other living things like plants, like animals, like different small creatures, there is a requirement of water. If you observe carefully, in human beings, in infants or in kids, yes, 2-3 years, in that kid, there is a different amount of water, that is a very less amount of water requirement in his body or in her body. But if you observe their parents' requirement, then their parents' requirement of water, it is high. Why this difference is there? Because there is a difference in size of their body. Your water requirement, your body's water requirement, it is different one if you compare with your parents. Yes, as there is a growth occur, there is a water requirement also increases. So the core point, it is water is very important one. But how this water form? If hydrogen gas burns in air, it combines with oxygen and water is formed. What is the formula for water? H2O. H represents hydrogen, O represents oxygen. And when these two gas they get combined, there is the formation of water. In previous standard, we discussed about the certain characteristics of water. Water, it is present in liquid state, it is colorless. Yes, whatever color we mix, that water get that color. Second activity is there. Here, if you observe this diagram, 1.5, distribution of water on earth, seas and oceans, groundwater, ice and water in other forms, water available for drinking. If you observe this diagram carefully, then the amount of water present in seas and ocean, it is very large amount. About 97% water, it is present in seas and oceans. Then groundwater, that is the underground water, ice and water in other forms, it is present in 2.7%. And for drinking purpose, the water available, it is 0.3% only. Yes, so if you observe, then large amount of water is present in the seas and ocean. And students, we know that the seas, the ocean's water, they are salty in nature. We can't drink that water. Yes, that means that water cannot be used for all these home activities, for drinking, for washing. Yes, we cannot use all the water on earth because sea water is salty. Some water is in frozen state. The ice glaciers are there. Yes, so in that there is a water, but it is in frozen state, and very small quantity of water is available, that is only 0.3% water is available for drinking, which is enough for all living things. Now here question is there, in what ways is the water in seas and oceans useful even though it is salty? For drinking purpose, that water cannot be used. Then how it is useful? The answer is here. Okay, for which purposes is water being used? We use water in large quantities. We have learned that water on earth is regulated through the water cycle. Water cycle. Do you remember this point? Water cycle? Answer of this question. Yes? How it is useful? The seas and oceans water. So in water cycle, if you remember, then the water from seas and oceans, from that there is a vapors are formed. Water vapors are formed. From that there is a formation of clouds. That clouds, when they get cool, yes, in the form of rain, they come on the ground. In this way, this salty water, that is the ocean water, sea water, can be used through the water cycle. And water cycle, it is the main source, because agar aap socho, agar water cycle nahi hogi, to rain formation hoga kya? No. Aur agar rainy season mein agar rain nahi hua, to it creates a imbalancing in nature. Water scarcity aa jayegi. Yes, and water scarcity, it leads into the many problems. Because if you observe this picture, 1.6, uses of water on earth, for which purpose we use? Here if you observe that a dam is there. Yes, in our Nanded area also Vishnupuri dam is there. Yes, and from this dam, suppose here there is a electricity generation plant from water. After that, for farming purpose also water is used. Here the sand, it is used from the water through tanker. There is a supply of water in small villages. Yes, here certain ladies, they wash clothes. That means for cooking, for washing, for bathing, we required water. Even in industrial area, in industries, for electric generation, there is a requirement of water. We get water from natural resources such as streams, rivers, ponds, springs, and lakes. Man also digs well and bore wells to lift ground water. In underground, there are the different springs, and with the help of bore wells or wells, we can collect that water, we can use that water. Apart from these, man also constructed bunds and dams of various sizes on rivers. So the main use of that dam, it is to store the water. Due to the uncontrolled use of water for an increasing population, industry and farming, it is now in short supply. Water scarcity has become a serious problem because day by day the population is increased very fastly, and to fulfillment their requirement of water, they continuously use the water. अभी आप सोचिए कि population increase हो गया तो basic requirements भी, उनकी demand भी क्या हो गई, बढ़ गई. Which are our basic requirements? Food, shelter, clothes. That means farming is there, and farming it is depend upon the water. अगर बारिश नहीं हुई, अगर पानी नहीं मिला तो farming हो पाएगी क्या? No. अगेन फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन पर्पस अगर आप देखेंगे तो वाटर तो रिक्वायरमेंट कंस्ट्रक्शंस के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा यूज़ किया जाता है. यस, सो इंक्रीजिंग पॉपुलेशन दैट मीन्स नंबर ऑफ हाउसेस ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस, नंबर ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस. फॉर दैट पर्पस ऑल्सो देर इज़ अ ह्यूज यूज ऑफ दैट वाटर. एंड इन दिस वे नाउडेज वी आर फेसिंग the water scarcity in summer season. And in if continuously we are wasting water, carelessly if use that water, then in future there may be crisis for water, scarcity of water may be arise. So always remember, what use of water sparingly. Block water, let it percolate. As your requirement is there, you just use that water very carefully. Block water or let it percolate. What is the meaning of percolation? Percolation, that means jo water hai, that water get absorbed by that soil. It is called as the percolation. And if percolation is occur, then underground water level also increases, the level it get increases. Store water whenever possible. Instead of throwing it, we have to store water as much as possible. Reuse water wherever possible. Remember, stored water does not become stale at once. वाटर कभी भी ख़राब नहीं होता, कभी भी वो बासा नहीं होता. जैसे खाना या रोटी बासी होती है ना, एक दो दिन की रोटी हम नहीं खाते हैं, तो वाटर कभी भी, बिकॉज देर इज़ नो इफेक्ट. यस, एंड वी हैव टू यूज़ दैट वाटर वेरी केयरफुली. रीयूज कैसा कर सकते हैं? सपोज वन ग्लास ऑफ वाटर लिया और हाफ ग्लास ही हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट है. अभी आधा वाटर जो बच गया है, आधा ग्लास वाटर, वो क्या करेंगे? फेंक देंगे. इंस्टेड ऑफ थ्रोइंग दैट वाटर, यू कैन गिव दैट वाटर इनटू द पॉटेड प्लांट. यस, टू द पॉटेड प्लांट्स यू कैन गिव दैट वाटर. यस, so in this way students, water it is a second natural resource which is very important one. Now can you tell what is land made of? Is land flat everywhere? What do you see on land? Does man produce soil or land? What has man created on land? If a deep pit is dug in the ground, what do you find there? You have to think. What is land made up of? एक ग्राउंड है, yes? वहाँ पे हमको क्या दिख रहा है? सॉइल का लेयर. But that is not a final thing. Below that layer, certain another layer are there. Rock layer है, sand layer है, humus का layer है. And collectively from all these things, the land is made. Okay? Is land flat everywhere? No, it is not flat everywhere. What do you see on land? Plants are there, certain shrubs are there, stones are there. Does man produce soil or land? No, because it is a natural thing. It is naturally available. What has man created on land? जैसे मैंने अभी बोला कि ओपन प्लेस है, उस पर हम कंस्ट्रक्शंस करके कोई भी बिल्डिंग फॉर्म कर सकते हैं, कंस्ट्रक्ट कर सकते हैं. उसके अलावा हम प्लांटेशन कर सकते हैं. यस, डिफरेंट थिंग्स वी कैन बी सेटअप ऑन दिस लैंड. इफ अ डीप पिट इज डग इन ग्राउंड, व्हाट डू यू फाइंड देयर? डिफरेंट लेयर्स विल ऑब्जर्व. विच लेयर्स? Proper fine sand is there. After that, a soil layer is there. After that, below that layer, there is a small rocks. Again, if we go deep inside, then big rocks are there. Humus layer is there. So, in this way, there are the different layers we will observe, we will find. So, land, it is a third natural resources. We will continue this part in our next lecture. But for today's, you have a homework which is based on the water. Which one? First of all, you have to draw this table. Yes, and in that approximately note down the amount. You can take the help of your mother also. You can ask her ki how much water we use for cooking, for washing clothes, approximately 1 bucket, 2 bucket, 4 bucket. Yes, after that the next homework it is complete this table. So draw this diagram and this table also. Okay, this is your today's homework. Thank you.